Good morning to everybody. Thank you for this opportunity to brief you on a forthcoming trip, a state visit of the President and the First Lady to Malaysia. President Ferdinand R. Marcos Jr. and First Lady Maria Luisa Araneta Marcos were invited by the King of Malaysia to undertake a state visit to the country on 25th to 27th July 2023. During the visit, the President will have an audience with the King of Malaysia and a meeting with the Prime Minister Anwar Ibrahim to identify new areas of synergy between the two countries. During the visit, the Philippines will also meet with prominent Filipino and Malaysian business leaders to enhance bilateral trade and investment and to explore economic opportunities for the Filipino people. While in Malaysia, the President will have the opportunity to meet with the Filipino community living there and to personally inform them of his administration's plans and programs for overseas Filipinos. This reciprocal visit between the leaders of both countries in 2023 is a testament to the reinvigorated relationship between the Philippines and Malaysia. It is also timely as the Philippines and Malaysia will mark 60th anniversary of the establishment of diplomatic relations between the two countries. This ends the release that we're having now, and I'm open for questions. Thank you.
Maricel Halili, TV5.
Hi, ma'am. Good morning. Ma'am, ano po yung mga, do we expect any bilateral agreements that will be signed during the visit of President Marcos to Malaysia?
I can talk about the significance of the visit. And I think, as I mentioned earlier, during this meeting, we will meet with both a Malaysian king, the 16th king of Malaysia, and prime minister of Malaysia. And he will pursue bilateral cooperation in priority areas that are actually in support of the economic agenda of the country. And that will include agriculture, food security, tourism, digital economy, tourism, and will also focus on people-to-people exchanges. But there will be new areas that will be explored, and this would include the halal industry and Islamic banking. We're also expecting that with the meeting with key Malaysian businessmen and business leaders, this would hopefully generate investment pledges from Malaysian companies. As you all know, Malaysia is a top 10 trading partner of the Philippines and the top 22nd source of approved investments in the Philippines in 2022. Malaysia also ranks the top 20 in terms of source of tourist arrivals in 2023. As expected, the President will actively promote the Philippines as an attractive trade, investment, and tourist destination.
May we know who will be part of the delegation?
Thank you. Clearly, he will be joined by the First Lady, Luisa Araneta Marcos, and key cabinet officials, which would include, of course, the Secretary of Foreign Affairs, and cabinet members and secretaries from his economic team, largely because there is an activity in terms of meeting with the Malaysian businessmen and all. He's also expected to bring a business delegation to Malaysia as part of his trade and investment promotion during the state visit. The final detail in terms of the list will come closer to the date, and most likely PCO would be the one to release that. Yeah, thank you.
Okay, Eden Santos.
Hello, good morning po, Ambassador. Is there any possibility po na matackle or i-promote or kung ano maging pwedeng isabihin dun sa Maharlika Investment Fund sa Malaysia po sa pagbisita ng Pangulo. Kabilang na rin yung mga binabanggit po, Filipino and Malaysian business leaders.
Salamat sa tanong. Yes, it's very safe to presume and assume. It's very safe to assume that it will maybe be raised and promoted during this visit.
Okay, Christina Maralit, Manila Times.
Hey, good morning, ma'am. Ma'am, last March, the Malaysian Prime Minister Anwar Ibrahim and the President both agreed to have a more in-depth talk with regards to the Philippines' claim on Sabah. Would this be possibly taken up during the President's state visit?
I don't have a crystal ball in front of me, and it's very difficult to preempt the discussion. So I have no comment on whether it will actually be discussed. I think PCO would be in the best position to report after the meeting. There will be a meeting with the Prime Minister, and they will do their updates on it.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. Hannah Jane Sancho, SMNI.
Good morning, ma'am. Ma'am, mga ilan na po ang mga Pilipino ngayon sa Malaysia?
It's difficult to give the official estimates, but I'll share the following that I have with me at now. In terms of verified number of contracts of OFWs that went through the Migrant Workers Office in 2022, they've identified household service workers as almost about 14,488, or say roughly 15,000. And then when you have professionals, about 300, highly skilled, 700, semi-skilled, 800, general labor, some 260 or so, this, in 2022, this forms part of some 100,000 of Filipinos that are in Malaysia. But in terms of exact number, we don't have it. It's usually estimate that is given relative to Malaysia.
Well, makakasama po kaya sa agenda, ma'am, any topic or discussion para po dun sa welfare po ng mga OFWs in Malaysia?
He will be meeting with the Filipino community. That is one of the official programs of the president. And it's safe to assume that the programs of the government relative to the welfare, the promotion of the welfare of our migrant workers will be erased.
Last na po, ma'am. Meron po tayong inaasahan ng mga agreements na pipirmahan between Malaysia and the Philippines?
Right now, I don't have information on specific agreement that will be signed. But clearly, in terms of what will be pursued, is something that I already mentioned earlier.
Any other questions? I think we're good. Short and sweet. One more, pahabol.
Ma'am, do we have details na po who will be in charge, the caretaker, once the president leaves for Malaysia? Do we have info?
I think PCO would be in the best position to answer this.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. The caretaker of our government,
yes.
You mean? They usually announce it, isn't it?
Right.
They usually announce it closer to the date of the departure. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well, this ends our press briefing. Thank you very much, Ambassador Teresita Daza of the DFA, and thank you, Malacañang Press Corps.